These bolts on this tractor have been rusting for over 45 years. When you see these bolts, you're going to agree it's going to take some magic to get these off. I soaked this brake adjustment in penetrating fluid for 2 days and it is not moving. Now I could work on this for hours breaking this free, but we're going to use a little bit of science to dissolve all this rust and virtually almost spin it completely free by hand. So what miracle solution are we going to use? Just plain vinegar. Just wait to see what happens. So instead of fighting this for hours, I'm just going to let it soak in this for a couple of days. After a couple of days, you can just see the flaking rust. These almost unrecognized mechanical parts are starting to look like nuts and bolts again. Now when I reach down and start to move it, the bolts move by hand. Quite a difference compared to letting it soak in penetrating fluid all night. When parts come off like this, it makes you want to go out and work on the tractor. Amazing. Take a look at the transformation. I'm going to go through some more details on how we get this all cleaned up to look just like this and take another look at what we started with. Well, let me go through some of the details. In order to get the vinegar to stay on the part, we're going to take an old juice container. We'll cut the bottom off and then we'll take and cut a slit down the side and then we'll put a hole into the container so it'll slip right over the rod so we'll have a reservoir to be able to pour our vinegar over the part. This container will just slip right on into place. And with a hot glue gun, go ahead and seal up the crack and seal around the rod. And now that you've got it all sealed up, we'll fill it up with vinegar. Any vinegar will do, white vinegar, cider vinegar, whatever you've got around. Now, if any of the parts aren't coming off, like this one bolt, I just put it in for another day with the vinegar. I'd rather the vinegar do the work than me sit there and fight with it. Instead of throwing this old vinegar away, I'll put it into a peanut butter container and I'll use it to eat rust off of parts on another day. A little more soaking in the vinegar made a world of difference for this bolt. When you start to see how well this technique works, you'll start throwing all your other pieces into the vinegar to clean them up as well. There are times when I take a rusty part off, I'll just put it in that peanut butter jar and just let it soak until I'm ready to put the part back on. I could let it sit on the counter and do nothing, but might as well put it into the vinegar and let it continue to clean these parts up. This vinegar will clean these parts up so well, it'll almost feel like you're working with new pieces. And remember, some of these pieces that I'm pulling out are 45 years old, and I can assure you, this tractor was not garage kept. Now there's a couple other techniques that I usually use to make the parts go together a little better. If it's a threaded part, I'll use a die and just run it over the threads to make sure that everything is as clean and straight as I can possibly get it. When you do clean your threads up with a die, you can just take the nut and spin it on by hand. Yes, it took a little extra time to run the die through, but when you see this happen, it's worth it. And for the threaded female parts, I'll use a tap and clean those up too. It's details like this that make reassembling a joy. And if you do have to make adjustments, it is so much better, so much easier when everything moves proper. I also like to wire wheel all the parts. That just gets them real nice and clean. The vinegar works so well, I really didn't even need to wire wheel these parts. It just takes it up a notch. These are kind of the details that a mechanic on the clock might not do. But there is a time savings. Imagine taking a wrench to put all this back together when you could just spin it all on by hand. And it makes the job enjoyable. And while I'm in doing the job, I might as well replace some of these seals. This brake cross shaft seal, if it's not leaking now, it's gonna. You can just feel it's lost its elasticity and it's just cracking right out of there. Here's a fresh new seal. I won't have to worry about oil dripping out of the bottom of this tractor. These brake rod seals are in pretty bad shape. When you compare this one to a brand new one, they don't even look like the same part. So now that we've got everything all put back together, and we get everything all topped off with fresh fluid, then we'll turn the tractor on, make sure the hydraulics are in good shape, and we'll also run it backwards and forward and make sure that the brakes are adjusted properly. So next time you're looking at rust so bad that you don't know how you're going to work on this part, you'll recall this video with some of these concepts and it'll help you out. Well, I hope you have found this video useful, maybe entertaining. And if you did, please give the video a thumbs up. I'd appreciate it, and I'll see you next time.